Alexander Smirnoff, one of the Republicans' star witnesses in both the Hunter Biden investigation and, of course, the President Biden impeachment inquiry. Smirnoff was, of course, indicted last week for lying to the FBI, telling them falsely that President Biden and his son Hunter had made a $5 million bribe to Barisma. And it was revealed this week that not only did he lie to the FBI about it, but that his information, the dirt, as it's called, that he gave Republicans in the House of Representatives and prosecutor David Weiss, who is prosecuting Hunter Biden, the information he gave them, he says, was passed along to him by officials with ties to the Russian intelligence community. Smirnoff, it appears, is really nothing more than apparently just a Russian asset used to spread disinformation here in the United States that has effectively resulted in Hunter Biden being prosecuted and Joe Biden being, you know, dealing with the impeachment inquiry, whatever. The person who is in trouble here now, however, not necessarily Smirnoff, and it's certainly not either of the Bidens. It's Jim Jordan himself. Jim Jordan, the chair of the House Judiciary Committee, is the man who used this information, this fake information. I can't even say it's from Smirnoff. Fake information from Russian intelligence. Jim Jordan used this as the basis for the hearings he has been conducting for the last 13 months. He was in contact with Smirnoff, as were other Republicans on that committee and on the oversight committee, possibly including James Comer himself. So the real question is, when is the DOJ going to investigate these Republicans in the House for relying on this fraudulent information from a seemingly Russian asset? Did they know? Did they know where he got this information? And did they ignore it? Was there a cover-up? This is a massive scandal. Like, I don't know that I can correctly convey the gravity of what is going on here, folks, but this is massive. If these Republican lawmakers in the House of Representatives were knowingly using this Russian plant to get information, flimsy as it was at the time, and now we know, of course, it was completely fraudulent, but if that's what they're using to go after the Bidens, these people should be in jail. Jim Jordan should be prosecuted. James Comer should be prosecuted. At the very least, the DOJ needs to launch an investigation, subpoena these individuals like Jordan and Comer, get their text messages, get their emails, find out what they knew about these lies and when they knew it, and did they proceed with the lies because it helped them pursue their political agenda against the Bidens? And if it did, that is abuse of power. Could be considered fraud against the United States itself, and they should be prosecuted for that. But this story has another extra turn in it. Obviously, Smirnoff was the basis for David Weiss, the Trump-appointed U.S. attorney who was appointed by William Barr to investigate Hunter Biden. It was based on Smirnoff's information. But there's even more to that. Because according to Attorney General Bill Barr himself, former Attorney General, he was Attorney General at the time, the reason he appointed Weiss was because Trump came to him, yelled at him, why you're not doing anything with the Smirnoff information. So Barr gave it to Weiss and said, do something about this. And that, of course, is when the Hunter Biden investigation began. Weiss, of course, was recently, thanks to Merrick Garland and his utter incompetence, appointed as the special prosecutor in the Hunter Biden case. And it's all based on false information from a Russian plant. And Trump himself pushed it. So yeah, we need a DOJ investigation. And it needs to go beyond Comer and Jordan. It needs to go into Donald Trump. It needs to go into Bill Barr. Because these men pushed this information and forced the prosecutor to do this. Now Weiss himself, obviously not in the clear either. He should be investigated as well. And let me tell you something about the charges against Hunter Biden. If the Smirnoff information, which of course we now know is totally fabricated, if that was the initial basis of the investigation, if that's all they had to go on when they started the investigation into Hunter Biden, all the charges against him are likely going to be dropped. And here's why. Obviously, the tax charges against Hunter Biden, the gun charge against Hunter Biden, that's not related to anything Smirnoff said at all. But that was uncovered in the course of an investigation that began based on fraudulent information. So let me explain it to you this way. Let's make a little chain here. Let's say it originally starts with the false Smirnoff information. Based on this information, you get a subpoena to go get this information. Then from this information, you get a subpoena to go get this information, and then another one to go over here, and here's where you find the tax stuff and the gun stuff. Okay? Valid subpoena, right? But if this initial subpoena was based on false information, then this one over here never would have started. So a good lawyer would be able to go into court and make the argument that all of that evidence they have against Hunter Biden is inadmissible because it all originated from the fraudulent subpoena. This is a big deal. And I believe, by the way, that Hunter Biden should be held accountable for not paying taxes, for having an illegal gun. But if they screwed up the process by basing it all on originally fraudulent information, then you're going to lose all the evidence you have against him and he's going to go free. Republicans screwed the pooch on this one. The only question is, and why we need an investigation into it, is how far along did they get before they knew that all of this was fake, but they continued it anyway. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.